Next, we are going for the implementation of our PLA. So here number of product terms we are having is 4. So our PLA must have 4 AND gates, and the number of inputs what you are having is 3 inputs A, B and C. So our PLA will be having 3 inputs, and our PLA is having 2 outputs. So the number of OR gates what you will be having is nothing but 2 OR gates. And from this table you understand only one more thing, that is the function F1 is in complement form and F2 is in the true form. So for F1, in order to get the complement, you have to do some modification in the output. The main things what you have to remember is you need 4 AND gates and 2 OR gates and 3 inputs. Okay, now we'll go for implementation. So this is a PLA which is having 3 inputs. Here you are having an inverter buffer which will give the true output of the variable as well as complement output of the variable. So you are getting A bar and your B B bar and C C bar. So since we are having 4 product terms, we have drawn 4 AND gates, and since we are having 2 outputs, we have drawn, so we are having 3 inputs, we have drawn this A B C, and we are having 4 product terms, we have drawn 4 AND gates, and we are having 2 outputs, so we have drawn 2 OR gates. Okay, now we are going to program. The first term is nothing but AP, so we have to put a mark in the place of A. This is A, so in the place of A and in the place of B. Then second AC, this is A, so A and this is C, so we are putting mark. Then next one BC, this is B, so we are putting B. Then this is C. Okay, then A bar, B bar, C bar, so this is C bar, this is B bar and A bar. Now you come to the, now we have completed the product terms. Now we are coming to SOP. Now this AB, it is present in both the function F. This is F1, this is F2 and this is F1. Okay, this is F1 and F1 and F2. This AB is present both in F1 and F2, so we have put a cross in both F1 and F2. AC is present in F1 and both F2. Then BC is present only in F2, and A bar, B bar, C bar, it is present only in F1, so we take cross here. Then our function F1, it is nothing but complement. So output of this OR gates, we are giving to an XOR gate. So we are giving the output of OR gate to a XOR gates. Now please listen. The one of the input we are connected, this XOR gate is having two inputs. One output will be coming from the OR gates, and other input we are having this F1. Here you are having one input, here you are having one input. The F2 is in true form, so this line is 0, so we are programming it as 0. Why? Because in an XOR gate, if one of the input is 0, then output is nothing but equal to the other input. So we have connected it to 0. Now F1 we have connected it to 1. Why? Because in an XOR gate, if one of the input is 1, output is nothing but the complement of the input. So here you will be getting F1, and when it is going to this XOR gate, you will be getting F1 bar. Why? Because one of the gate of this XOR gate is made as 1. Okay, so we have got F1 bar here and we have got F2. So in the from the PLA programming table itself, we understand that the function F1 is in the complement form, so we have to clearly mention it in the output. So what we have done is, to the XOR gate which is connected to F1, we have we have connected a 1 to one of the input. So in the F2 we have connected to 0. So here you will be getting f1 bar and here you will be getting f2. So we got the correct functions. Now we are going for programmable array logic. So PAL means programmable array logic. So in this programmable array logic, only AND gate is programmable and OR gates are fixed and it is not programmable. Okay, so here AND gates are programmable and OR gates are not programmable, they are fixed. PAL is easy to program, but it is not flexible as PLA is easy to program, but it is not flexible as PLA. So in PLA, both AND gates as well as OR gates are programmable. So each input is having a buffer inverter gate. So similar to the PLA, here also each input will be having a buffer inverter gate. So we'll be getting a true as well as complement from form of the variable from the output of this inverter buffer gate. Each section is having three programmable AND gates and one fixed OR gate. In the PAL, you're having each section, you'll be having many sections, and each sections will be having three programmable AND gates and one fixed OR gate. The output of the first section is connected to a buffer inverter gate and then fed back into the input of AND gate. Okay, so the output of the first section we are feedback into the input. This allows the logic designer to feed an output function back to the input variable. The advantage of this is the designer can feed an output function back to the input variable. So there are two types of PAL. One is programmable input output PAL and next one registered output output PAL. So this registered output PAL will be having memory elements. Okay, this programmable input output PAL will not be having any memory elements, but this registered output PAL will be having memory elements. So this is a diagram of PAL. So it is having some 1, 2, 3, 4 sections. Each section will be having 3 AND gates and 1 fixed OR gate. So output of the first section is fed back to the input. Actually, it is having 3 inputs. And we can take it as A, B, C, D. The 4 inputs plus 1 feedback input. Okay. So we can take this as this is I1, I2, I3, I4 or A, B, C, D. 4 inputs and plus 1 feedback input, and each section will be having 3 AND gate and 1 OR gate. Here also 3 AND gate and 1 OR gate, and 3 AND gate and 1 OR gate, 3 AND gate and 1 OR gate. This is inverter buffer. Okay, buffer gate, inverter buffer gate. Another important thing what we have to remember is, so by using this, a term must have only 3 product terms. If you are getting more than 3 product terms, it is difficult to implement. So one particular expression must have only 3 product terms, because only you are having 3 AND gates. Okay, so if you want to implement product terms, then you need AND gates. But this PAL is a fixed structure and each section will be having 3 AND gate and 1 OR gate. Now we are going, this is programmable array logic, and you having fixed OR array and programmable AND array. So this is a diagram and it will be having inputs, 4 inputs, 1 feedback inputs and outputs. Each section will be having 3 AND gates and 1 OR gates. So now we are going for a problem. So here we are having 4 functions W, X, Y, Z, and each function is having 4 variables, and the function is in what SOP, and we have to implement by using PAL. So similar to the PAL, first step is we have to minimize this expression by using KMAP. Okay, So the given function we have to minimize by using k-map. So first, this is a expression for this is a k-map for w. See how we have plotted the given number of ones, and we are writing the expression. The expression for this group is a, b, c bar, and the expression for the single one is a bar, b bar, c, d bar. Similarly, the expression for x is we are plotting the given min terms and we are grouping. Here we are having one pair and one octet. The expression for this octet is a. The expression for this pair is nothing but b, c, d, and we have written. Now this is a k-map for y. So we have plotted the given min terms and we are grouping the ones. And the expression for this quad is nothing but a bar b, and expression for this quad is nothing but c d, and the expression for this quad is nothing but b bar d bar. So we have written the expression. Then we are going for z. We have plotted the given min terms, we have grouped and we have written the expression. Now all the previous product expression is having only less than four product terms. That is, it is having three product terms or less than three product terms. But this expression for z is having 1, 2, 3, 4 product terms. So this can't be implemented. But a few terms are similar to that of w. So we'll check in the next. So this is the expression for w, and this is the expression for x, this is the expression for y, and this is the expression for z. But the first two terms or two terms of z is similar to that of w. So we are writing the expression z as w plus a c bar d bar plus a b a bar b bar c bar d. Okay, so whether it is clear. So actually this is the expression for x, the w, this is the expression for x, this is the expression for y, and the first two terms of z is similar to that of w. So I am writing z as w plus a c bar d bar plus a bar b c bar d. Okay, now we are going for PAL programming table. So it is here there is a slight difference between our previous PLA programming table and PLA. There is a difference between PLA programming table and PAL programming table. In PLA programming table, initially you are having product terms. Here you are just writing the number of the product terms. Then inputs are same. So the first, and we are writing the output for W here. W is equal to A B C bar plus A bar B bar C D bar. So in the place of A you are putting 1, in the place of B you are putting 1, in the place of C you are putting 0, because it is C bar, so you are putting 0. D is variable is not present, we are putting dash. W is not there, we are putting dash. Similarly, you are writing for A bar B bar C D bar, 0 0 1 0. That third term is not there, so we have put dash. Similarly for next one, first A, second one B, C, D. So we put one in the place of B and C and D. In the other places you are putting dash. Here also you are having dash. Here also you are putting dash. Next third term is not available. Now you come to the third term. So B bar next term is B bar D bar. This is B bar D bar. Next one C D. This is C D. And A bar B, this is A bar B. Now you come to the last term W. You are putting one in the place of W, all dash. Next one A C bar D bar 1, B is not present, dash, C bar 0, D bar 0. Next A bar 0 0 0, and in the place of D 1, and W is not present, we have put a dash. So we have completed the PAL programming table. So we have not mentioned the product term individually, and totally we are writing the expression and we are writing that. So from this PAL programming table, so all the terms is having only less than three product terms. The first W is having only two product terms. Similarly, X is having two, Y is having three, and Z is having three. So we can implement by using PAL. Now this is nothing but the PAL. So here you are having three. Each section is having three AND gates and one OR gate. Okay. So the first term from the previous diagram, A B C bar. A B C bar. Then next one, A bar B C D bar. A bar B bar C D bar. Okay. Similarly, we are programming and we are implementing by using this PAL. So W, we are having one feedback term W. So Z is having one term W that we are programming here. Okay. So we have done that problem by using PAL. So similar problems can be asked in the exam. The first step what you have to do is you have to go for K-map simplification. After that, you have to get that expression and you have to clearly check that the expression must have only three product terms. If it is having more than three product terms, you check any other the terms which is present in the expression which is having greater than three product terms is similar to some other expression. So if it is similar, then expression that you write the sum of that term plus this term. So we'll be getting the number of product terms three or less than three. Okay. So you can implement by using this PAL. So today we have studied ROM, PLA and PAL. Now types of PLDs, once again we can say. So three types we have studied. First one, ROM. In ROM, both the AND array and we are having AND array is not programmable, but OR array is programmable in where ROM. But in the case of PAL, AND array is programmable, OR array is not programmable. But in PLA, both AND array and OR array are programmable. Once again, I am telling in ROM, OR array is programmable and AND array is not programmable. In PAL, AND array is programmable and OR array is not programmable. But in the case of PLA, both AND and OR array are programmable. So is by using programmable logic devices, we can reconfigure the circuit. Initially, it will not be having any fixed function, and the user can reconfigure it depending upon his need. So implement the following two Boolean function with a PLA having three inputs, three product terms and two outputs. So we are going to see this problem. So in this problem, they have given that you are having two Boolean functions F1 and F2. And you have to implement it by using three inputs. So here they are given only the functions, they have not given the variables. So you take the variables as A, B and C. And we have to do it by three product terms and through two outputs. So F1 and F2 is nothing but the outputs. Okay. So in PLA, the first step what we have to do is we have to minimize the expression by using K-map. Here the largest number given in this two terms is 7. So in order to represent 7, you need only 3 bits. So you have to draw a 3 variable K-map. So we are going for simplification. So we have drawn a 3 variable K-map and we have plotted the this is a K-map for F1. Here you are having two functions f1 and f2. First we are drawing the k-map for f1, and you are having three ones, and we have grouped like this. And the expression for this one is nothing but ac, and expression for this one is bc. So the came by minimizing the expressions for f1, we have got it as ac plus bc. Okay, now this is the k-map for f2. Okay, so by plotting the min terms of f2, we have got ones in 4, 5 and 7. So we are grouped like this. The expression for this one is nothing but this pair is a b bar, and for this pair is a c. Okay, so you got the expression. Now we have to check the number of product terms. So here you are having ac plus bc, and here you are having a b bar plus ac. So totally you are having only three, I mean totally you got four product terms. Out of that four, this ac is coming both in f1 and f2, so we have to take only one. So you are getting only three product terms. Okay, so without any modification, by using f1 and f2 itself, we can implement. Okay, so we are going for the PLA programming table. This is the PLA programming tables. The product terms of are AB bar, AC and BC. These are the inputs A, B and C. Here AB bar, so you have to put 1 in the place of A and 0 in the place of B, and C is not present, you have to put a dash. Similarly, this is present only in F2, so you have to put 1 in the place of F2. Now AC, this AC in the you are putting 1 in the place of A and 1 in the place of C. The variable B is missing, so a dash. Next to one, A is missing here in the BC, so you put a dash and 1 for B and 1 for C. This AC is present both in F1 and F2, so we have put 1 in the place of F1 and F2. BC is present only in F1, so we have put 1 in the place of F1. Now we have not taken any complements, so both the F1 and F2 are in true form. So we put T in the place of F1 and F2. Now we are going for the implementation. So this is ABC. So this is the inverter buffer gate. So you are getting the true form as well as the complement form of the variables. Here you are having only three product terms, so we have considered only three AND gates. And first product term is A B bar. So in the place of A and the place of B bar, we have programmed. Similarly, A C in the place of A and in the place of C. Next to B and C. This A B bar is present only in F2, so you crossed F2. Similarly, AC is present in the F1 and F2, so we have crossed both. Similarly, BC is present only in F1. Okay, now both are in true form. So in the XOR gate, the one of the input is 0, so we have crossed both the 0 lines. So this is the implementation of this problem. Okay, so in the previous problem, we have we have asked to implement by using four product terms, but by while minimizing the functions f1 and f2, we have got six product terms. After that, we have taken the complements of f1 and f2. After comparison, we understand that by considering f1 bar and f2, our four product term condition is satisfied. So we have taken and we have implemented. Okay, so next, BCD2 7 segment display decoder. We have to implement the BCD2 7 segment display decoder using PLA. So whatever may be the problem in combinational circuit, in exam they may be sometime asking you to implement by using PLA, either BCD2 gray converter or gray to BCD converter or something. You have to implement by using PLA. So here I am taking an example, BCD2 7 segment display decoder. Already we have studied. Okay, so this BCD2 7 segment display decoder, I am asking and we are going to do it by using PLA. Implement by using PLA. You know what is in place on segment display decoder. Actually, sound segment display display is present in LED and LCD displays, and it accepts a decimal digit in BCD and generate the appropriate outputs. Okay, this is nothing but the seven segments. Okay, of a sound segment display. So for a particular number, decimal number, for zero, A, B. For a particular number, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So if it is zero, except G, all are enabled. For one, only B and C is enabled, and another segments are disabled. Similarly, for 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Okay. So now we are directly we are going for the what this truth table. So here the inputs are A, B, C, D. You know that BCD numbers you are having from 0 to 9, and respective segments which is enabled. We are having 7 segments, so we are writing from small a to g. Then what we are going to do is we are putting 1 for the particular segments enabled, and we are giving 0 for the particular segments disabled. Okay, for 0, only G is disabled and all the others are enabled. Similarly, for 1, only B and C are enabled and all the others are disabled. Similarly, we are writing up to 9. So here you are having only 4 inputs and 7 outputs. So you have to go for 7 4 variable K maps. So you have to draw 7 4 variable K maps. Okay, this is a K map for A. So we have checked the column of A, and we have to plot the wants and don't cares. Similarly, one more thing I have to tell is here we are having 4 inputs, that is A, B, C, and D. So if you are having 4 inputs, you'll be having 16 combinations, but we are using only from 0 to 9. You are using from 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. For 15, you have to put don't cares. Okay. So 0 to 9, you have to put values. From 0 to 9, if you are having ones, you have to plot. Okay. Then from 10 to 15, you have to put don't cares. After that, you have to group and you have to write the expression. Okay. This is the grouping. And this is not capital A, this is small a. So we are writing the expression for A. Similarly, for so already we have done the same problem. Similarly, we are doing it for B. Similarly, C. Similarly, D. And E. F and G. Okay. So after writing the expression, so we have to collect all the expressions. Okay. So now previously we have done it by using ordinary gates and all. Here also we are going to do it by gates, but here we are going to do it by PLA. Okay. So here we are going to implement this BCD to 7 segment display decoder by using PLA. So first, after writing the expressions, we have to check how many common product terms you are having. The A. This A is present in the small a, small d, the small f, and small g. Similarly, C. C is present only in this A. BD. This BD is present in A and B. Similarly, this B bar, D bar, it is present in A, D, and E. Similarly, this C bar, D bar, it is present in B and F. Okay. So we have to check the common terms. So from this we understand that we are having 7 common terms and 8 independent terms. Totally we are having 15 terms. So in PLA we have to select 15 AND gates. Okay, so what we have to do, we have to use 15 AND gates. And how many outputs you are having? 7 outputs. So we have to take 7 OR gates. So now we are going for the implementation. We have selected 15 AND gates and 7 OR gates, and these are the inputs A bar, B, B bar, C, C bar, D, D bar. Okay, now these are the product terms that we are going to we are going to program. Okay, so A, so in the place of A put a mark. Here C, we have to place put a mark. B, D, similarly B bar, D bar. Now, then we have to check this A. It is present in A, then D, F, G. So you have to put cross mark. Similarly, C. C is present only in C. So you have to only in A. So you have to put a cross mark. Similarly, you have to program it. So this is nothing but implementation of BCD to 7 segment display decoder by using PLA. The only difference is after getting the expressions, you have to check the common terms and independent terms. So by going through this expressions, we understand that we are having 7 common terms. Common terms means it will be present in more than one expression. So we are having 7 common terms and 8 independent terms. So totally we got 15 product terms. So we need 15 AND gates to implement this 15 product terms. And in order to implement this output, 7 outputs, we need 7 OR gates. So totally, so we are used to 15 AND gates and 7 OR gates. And we have programmed, first we have drawn this AND gates and OR gates. After that, we have programmed. Okay, this is nothing but the implementation of BCD to 7 segment display decoder using PLA. So if it is asked for binary to gray and we ask you to implement using PLA, what you have to do is first you have to do the problem, you have to get the expression. No need to go for minimization and all. Okay, but you take the expression, you get the common terms, you get the independent terms. After that, you must know how many AND gates you need. So how many AND gates means you check how many, totally how many product terms you are getting. So after that, how you take the AND gates, then you check how many outputs you are having. So you take as much number of OR gates, then you implement, you will be getting the PLA. Okay, implementation of that particular circuit by using PLA.